was the year the world will not forget in a hurry. And that is because the COVID-19 pandemic became a global phenomenon, affecting lives, affecting homes, schools, and businesses. What are the effects of COVID-19 on students across the world? This and more are what we'll be discussing today on Control Niger, a platform where we give young people the opportunity to talk about issues as it affects them. Control Niger is powered by WakeUpAfrica360.com, and I am your host, Akuda Bingowe. Welcome to the show.
Chika Azubike.
So good to have you on the show, Chika.
Thank you.
Welcome. Thank you for coming. And here we have
Chekwas Anaga Nana.
So nice to have you on the show, Nana. Thank you for coming.
No problem.
So we are going to be talking about how students are currently coping with academics after the COVID-19 lockdown. Let me even start with, how were you able to survive the COVID lockdown period? What were you doing within those months that were on lockdown?
When it first happened, we were not doing anything in school actually. But like third month or fourth month, now said we should finish our semester by doing online exam and online lectures.
Okay.
So we finished our semester, then we got our results and everything. That's how it was basically.
Wow. So you were quite busy with academics,
yeah,
even though there was lockdown. Chika, how did you cope during that COVID-19 period? How did you cope generally?
Actually, I was just busy making some researches on my studies.
Okay.
I got some online materials and I had to study them before the school resumes.
So you were quite busy researching.
Yeah,
So it's safe to say that my two guests were busy during COVID-19. It didn't affect us. Some of us were actually watching only TV. Okay, but now, before COVID-19, Nigeria, I don't know about other parts of Africa, but Nigerian education system at that point had not embraced online studies, online academics. It was something that, it was like an emergency solution. So, and you know, when they started talking about online academies, I was initially confused. It took me a while to really get a grasp of the whole thing. And I'm sure that must have been the same for you, Nana.
Yeah,
so how did you, when you first heard online, you're going to navigate online, how did you perceive it? What was your reaction?
At first, I was lost. I was like, online, how are we going to do that? How are teachers going to talk to us? Then they now brought out like this. There are these apps we use in school, Google Classroom and Edmodo. They're like easier for us to gain lectures and get notes on lectures that lecturers will give us. After they introduced those apps, everything became easier than how it was before.
Oh. Would you say studying online is a way to go, you know, for future academic courses, being that now a lot of Nigerian schools have added it as part of their academic activities?
Yeah, it's quite easy. It's a way to go, but not everyone is actually used to that kind of learning. Some of us are used to handling papers and all that. While some are good at studying online, their computers and phones and tablets and all that. So it's a way to go, but it actually affects some of us in a way of assimilating information. We are not equal in terms of information assimilation. So I think the government should actually create a space whereby it will suit both those that can learn online and those that are better off learning with papers.
Okay. But is it every school that has adopted online academics? Is it every school?
No, not, I don't think so.
So which particular schools? Is it more of private universities that adopted it?
More private universities have adopted online.
So now I'm going to ask both of you. So before now, we have what I would call, I don't know much about if it happens often like that in private universities, but in government universities, federal universities, you have what we call errant lecturers. You know, lecturers who don't show up for classes, but they end up, you know, just giving you materials you read on your own. On the days that they're supposed to be in class, they are not there. So the students basically just teach themselves. That used to happen in the past. I mean, that happened in my time. Now, if we're adopting online studying, how would that affect, you know, this situation where you have a lecturer not showing up for classes? What do you think? I just want everybody's opinion.
If a lecturer doesn't show up for online classes, that's going to really affect the students of that course, because without the lecturer coming to explain the materials he has given, the students can actually be lost, and that might affect them very, very bad for them.
Wow.
Yeah. So, well, I think the lecturer not showing up will actually cause some lapses in terms of explaining the materials, and because the students have to go extra mile to really understand that particular course.
So it's safe to say that online learning now holds lecturers accountable.
Yeah,
because
yes.
Now you don't have any excuse not to come to classes, because you must be there on ground to teach the students. But if we do a study across universities and we ask students off camera, because you know people tend to be a bit free when there's no camera before them, and we ask them online studying and offline studying, which do you prefer? What do you think would be their response number?
I think offline. Everybody offline.
You think that we prefer offline? What about you, Tika?
I would prefer online.
You prefer online? Yeah. Oh, really? And you think students out there would prefer online too?
It's actually their choice. I don't know.
Wow. I think I would go with Nana that they would prefer offline. Because, right. I mean, it's still very new. And, you know, because before now, Nigeria hasn't reached the peak of internet, online usage. So the whole online thing just came, you know, it was a shock. Like I said, it took me a while to understand how it works and all of that. And that takes me to the use of the usage of data when you're accessing materials online. We still don't have free data usage in Nigeria. We pay for the data we use. And it's not very cheap, to say the least. So what amount of data do you consume when you study online, Chika?
It's actually a good question, because even now, most universities do give their students free data on campus.
Oh, really?
Maybe like this week, like in my school do give away about 20 gigabytes per semester. So I think that should be enough to access data online.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So your school is helping the students to be able to access studying online so that they won't complain that data is a problem.
Yeah.
So Nana, what do you think is the actual impact on the usage of data for young people, students in school?
Data usage, everybody's not thinking of how to get data for this class, get data for that class. But in school, before this online stuff started, they used to give us Wi-Fi. They have this Wi-Fi in our halls.
Okay.
We use them. But now that we are home, we complain to them that we don't have data. We cannot be buying our own data to access classes.
Okay.
And at the point, they're giving us like 10 gig, like per week. But at the point though, like when we now resumed offline lectures, now stopped. So that's